Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us is unappropriated retained earnings. Well, this is a part of the shareholders' equity. We always refer to unappropriated to the retained earnings. Whenever we talk about retained earnings, shareholders' equity always come into pictures. Let's try and understand first and the foremost thing, what is URE? So in simple terms, the URE, that is the unappropriated retained earnings, is that part of the net income earned by the firm that does not have a specific use outlined in the current frame of time. Now, the management might have an idea of how they want to use it. They might like to work on all scenarios and simulate future cash flows before executing this idea. So if it works out, then it's really good. But it does not, then the management is legally bound to disclose or implement the idea. In any case, all part of the money that can be distributed to the shareholders, dividend. Now, the next thing that I want to discuss is how does the URE work? How exactly this works? Well, considering the IT consulting firm, Photon has, let's say, $5 million of reporting revenues, and eventually, you know, let's say $1 million in retained earnings. In retained earnings, RE. So not all the amount is automatically going to be offered for the payment to the shareholder in the form of dividends. The board of director believe that, you know, it will be in the best interest of the firm to expand. Hence, decide to keep, let's say, $6 lakh to reinvest their money and to be called as appropriated retained earnings, since there are no such plans for 4 lakh, that is for 4 lakh as of now. This will be calculated as the unappropriated URE, right? The whole part of the amount can be distributed to the shareholders as dividend. Considering the following, you know, table that I'm going to prepare for you. It's 5 million. Then we have expenses that goes in, right? 4 million. The net retained income is as simple as that. Just deduct both of this above. And from that, the appropriated retained earnings is how much? 6 lakh. So when you deduct, just deduct one from here, so it will be $4 lakh. This is used, let's say, for the purchase of land, and this can be distributed as dividends or dividend payment. Right now I will take you to why the unappropriated retained earnings are important for the investors. See, unappropriated retained earnings are the profits. What is it? It's called the profits. They are the profits that have not been spent, nor there is a plan to do so, since they are not directed towards the specific purpose by the board. So they are available to be paid as the dividends, right? They are paid as dividends. So in fact, unappropriated retained earnings helps to determine the maximum dividend, and that can be paid out to the shareholders. So the greater the URE, the higher, okay, the dividend that can be possibly be rewarded. And mathematically, it can be expressed as dividend is equal to maximum of what? Maximum of URE zero. So this earnings are distributed among all the outstanding shareholders or shareholders of the company and paid out as dividend as per the predetermined dividend payment schedule. Now I'll take you to the third part. Why URE exactly matters? See, there are changes in the level of the URE, and it can send a signal. It can send a signal to the investor about the future plans of the company. So an increase in the value, for example, could mean that, you know, the company is planning to invest less in business in the near future. So though this releases the cash that could be paid out of the shareholder, this might not be the best course of action if the sector is in which the company operates demands better machinery, equipment and talent or other assets in order to remain competitive. So in simple terms, the company has what we call as run out of the ideas, and that can help it grow both organically and inorganic growth. and looks upper capped. In such a scenario, you know, the company might not be able to deliver the healthy growth rate. Right, and that is was delivering till yet. So this would eventually affect the return on equity, the ROE, the share price, as an investor would like to withdraw the investment and park it in the company that can offer better growth. Now, there are some exception part that I wish to discuss. See, it can be restrained, especially when the firm has both the preferred stock and the common stock. Preferred stock and the common stock. So like, for example, the preferred stock can have the priority over the holder of the common stock. So in this case, the payment of the dividend from the unappropriated retained earnings is said to be restricted. It's called as restricted. Now, speaking practically, all the balances in the account of the retained earning belongs to the owners. And until they are paid out for the purpose, in the event of the company insolvency or bankruptcy, both you would be used to pay off the creditor with any remaining amount distributed to the owners. Now, what are the accounting implications? See, the URE are reported in the owner's equity. Okay. Now, section owner's equity section of the balance sheet. So these are regulated via the generally accepted accounting principle GAAP. Okay, for example, if the firm subsidiary issues dividend after the parent company have issued financial statements, then the subsidiary company should disclose via the formal document, like, you know, pro forma trial balance or pro forma financials. Second, you know, it only specifies the earning but does not specify the circumstances in which they were earned. In accordance with the GAAP, companies should specify the concerned information related to the earning part, the earnings in the form of the notes or the corporate documents. Like, for example, if they have reduced due to the change in the accounting method, such should be duly be disclosed in the financials. So, based on this, let me make my conclusions. See, financial statement, they both are explicitly and implicitly say a lot about the company. The URE, okay, form an important section, and the statements, as they express a lot about the management, its growth strategy and the firm's growth prospect. If evaluated properly, this can be an important for the investor before they park their money in the firm.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.